The COVID-19 pandemic is proving to be one of the greatest challenges of our generation. We are facing a health emergency that poses a significant threat to our physical well-being and that of our families and our loved ones. The widespread ramifications of this emergency and the steps that must be taken to combat it mean that our way of life is changing. As a result, many people are also suffering socially and economically. In these unprecedented times, it is understandable that people are feeling anxious, distressed, and vulnerable. There is much uncertainty in the face of this crisis, but there are also things that are certain. First, we are not alone. Every one of us is potentially affected by this pandemic. No one is exempt. At the same time, we are physically distancing ourselves from one another. We need to remain connected in spirit. More than ever, it is important to extend kindness to one another, to look out and care for each other, and to ensure that our actions and words reflect the society that we are, a society that is harmonious, resilient, respectful, and decent, a society that believes in the common good. Second, we all have a role to play. History judges a society not only on the outcome of a crisis, it will also look to how society grappled with that crisis. The actions of each of us will play a crucial part of the collective effort to overcome this pandemic. It is imperative that we follow official directives and guidance to ensure a consistent and unified response. Acting in this way means that we are protecting each other, including the vulnerable members of our community. Third, this crisis will pass. Our society has survived many, many crises, and there is no reason why this one should be an exception. If we act in solidarity, we will lessen the damage. I would like to express my sincere condolences to those people who have lost loved ones as a result of this pandemic. My thoughts are also with business owners and employees who have suffered great loss and are enduring hardship. Let's all make sure that we do what we can to support businesses that are doing it tough. I want to offer my heartfelt thanks to everyone in our community who is either directly or indirectly working in response to this crisis. Frontline health workers, aged care workers, law enforcement personnel, teachers, childcare workers, supermarket staff, government employees, and volunteers. We are grateful for your service and the commitment that you display to our community. It was only recently that our state suffered the devastating bushfires. My wife, Lan, and I were moved by the courage, resilience, and compassion our community displayed during this time. Let us continue to uphold these values in the way that we respond to the emergency we are facing now. Lan and I are thinking of the people of South Australia. We hope that everyone takes care of themselves and others. We will get through this together.